So for those who don't know me, I'm Teresa's sister, Christina. And it's my honor to speak on behalf of all the guests from the Czech Republic. Milujeme tě, Teresko. We wanted for you the best husband in the world, and you chose Aiden. So, Aiden, we hope you can live up to the expectations. And welcome to the family. We have lots of memories with Teresa from her first business. When she was 60 years old, she used to write love letters for her classmates. She got paid in lollies, now she gets paid in dollars, it is better. Well, we've been through a lot, all our ups and downs, our first drinks, parties, and love. And we are so proud of you, Teresa. Coming to the other side of the world, all by yourself, speaking the language you hated so much at school. Thank you for importing me in case to the country where we found our love in our home. We loved the crazy girl that left the Czech Republic 5 years ago, and we loved the woman who became the woman who can make people travel across the whole world for her, and the woman who makes her family so proud.
So after the ceremony, kick back, relax, and help these guys to celebrate. Here we go. Aiden and Teresa, you made promises to one another, and you've exchanged rings as a symbol of your love. On behalf of all gathered here today, I extend to you our love, our good wishes, our friendship and support of the commitment you have made to one another. May your love strengthen and grow through all the experiences that life has to offer you. And now gives me the greatest pleasure to pronounce your husband and wife. Aiden, you may kiss your beautiful bride.
Aiden, it's great to see you. You should pick one. Yeah. I think you've made a fantastic choice here. If you're looking for the ideal partner, you'd be looks pretty damn good. Check or check.
Oh, I can see you.
Great cook. Great cook and cleans as well. Check. Likes to go fishing. Check. And enjoys a nice beer. What else could you want?
Oh, Tereza, we actually done it. How beautiful does my wife look? We would not be probably sitting here today if it wasn't for my, for one special person, for one special thing. It'd be my dog Cooper. As most of you know, Cooper wasn't the most well-behaved dog. But that night when we first met, Tereza thought I was a bit of a dick. I was trying way too hard, and which doesn't sound like me, but she wouldn't stop talking about how much she loved animals, especially dogs. So when Tereza and her sister Christina dropped me home, I seized that opportunity, opened the gate. Big Cooper comes running out, walking around, straight into the car, straight into Tereza, licking her face. He's like, oh yeah, got it.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. and Mrs. Cox.